Okay, we are back with more Skylanders Spyro's Adventure. In the last video, we defeated Chaos, and now we're going to continue with the adventure packs. Now, the first one here is the Empire of Ice. It is, it's the one that has, who's on the screen right now, Slam Bam, and includes the Empire of Ice, the Anvil Rain, and the shield. I can't remember what the exact name of the shield is. But I'll show all of those, the two magic items, in the video. So let's warp in to the Empire of Ice.
Greetings, young portal master. Haldor, the great northern wizard, needs your help. You must go with him at once to save his village of Gladablum, which is locked in the icy grip of endless winter by the evil Ice Ogres. Hurry! The Empire of Ice awaits!
Okay. This is the entrance to the Empire of Ice. You can actually go here at any time. You don't need the Empire of Ice on the Portal of Power, so it'll be here, even after you take it off. Oops. Let me get back on here. Alright, so this one's interesting because this is the only ice level in the game. The 3DS version actually has a whole ice world. But yeah, let's hit in.
Oh, thank the good wahoos you came. Ooh, and you came just in time. Name's Haldor. Can you believe this here icy wasteland used to be a sunny paradise? Flowers and grass and the nicest weather you ever did see. Yeah, I know. Sounds great. And it was! Until those ugly stacked-eyed noodle-necked ice ogres moved in and changed everything! First, they built a giant wall that blocked the warm sun, locking this place in an endless winter. Then they started marching all over, like they owned the place. And that's when the snowball fight started. But they messed with the wrong wizard. Wahoo! They surely did, because I have a plan. Ain't she a beaut? The ultimate snowball launcher. Sure, she's a bit of a fixer-upper. But once she's all put together, I'll never lose a snowball fight again! And careful walking on this ice now. It's slippery.
Okay. So, this is the Empire of Ice. A very cool place. No pun intended. Maybe. Okay, these are new enemies here. The Frozen Fiends. Oh, they're pretty weak enemies. Let me take care of them one hit, just like the other variations of them. The cacti, the ice cacti, just watch out for them. They actually do hurt. Look, watch. Yeah. Just a little bit, but yeah, you still want to avoid them. And if you do have the 3DS version, you will learn to hate those, because those are everywhere in the ice levels. Empire of Ice on 3DS is actually completely different from this one, too. It's more like techie, I guess you could say. There's more. It's not really icy since they have that whole ice world. Up ahead is, I think, there's a new enemy right here too. Yep. Chukka. All right. As his name implies, he just threw snowballs at you. All right. So, like I said, this adventure pack comes with Slam Bam, who you see here. I've used them a couple times already in the playthrough, so not really much to say about that. Okay, there's an undead gate up there. Let me just collect these, I guess. Oh, wait. There's a little area here. I think this is where you get the soul gem. Or yeah, it is. It's on the top left. And we have a treasure chest here too. Actually, I'm gonna grab it as him because I need his soul gem. Okay. The first time I played this level, I remember like that treasure chest. Like some of the treasure was like floating in midair, so I couldn't grab it. It was kind of annoying. Actually, we've seen that a couple times in the playthrough too. Okay, there's a Yeti cooling factor soul gem. Well, we're gonna preview him anyway, even though we're playing as him, just because. So, yep. Once you upgrade him to a certain point, he actually gets this ice armor. It actually looks really cool to him. Actually, I'm kind of used to seeing him like that. It looked kind of weird that he wasn't wearing the armor. I mean, the toy, he doesn't have the armor either, but... yeah. If I remember right, in the second game, for the reposed figures, Slayman will have his armor on the actual figure. On the Series 2 figure. So that'll be cool. We're gonna warp out of here. Okay, this is back where we were before. We're gonna head up to the undead gate here.
You need an undead Skylander to unlock.
First, I kind of forgot about putting that on there. Oops. And then undead. Let's go with. Legendary chop chop.
This now you can find the special hidden dragon treasure.
Okay. Oh, not this part. Yeah, you have to collect all the skulls here in a certain amount of time, but these snowballs get in the way and it's very slippery here. So it's not really as easy as it seems, sometimes. Your movement is very limited, too. Oops. I think the first time it took me about 3 tries to do this one. Maybe 4. But yes, it took me quite a few tries to actually get all of them in one go. Mainly because of those things. You have to, like, get a momentum to get some of these, too, if you notice. Oops. See, that just stopped my momentum. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna get it this time. I have to go through again. I can't reach that. Okay, there's 2 more. I don't know if I can get it in 10 seconds, though. I'm already running out of time. Well, the good thing is, like, you just have to start over again. Oh, I was about to get that one. There's no consequence. You just have to start over again, that's all. I mean, that is kind of a consequence, but at least you don't, like, die or lose health. Okay. I would really try getting those higher up ones first, because they're harder to reach. That and you have to get the running start to get them. There we go. I have almost all of them, actually. Oh, I thought I got the one up there. Okay. I might be able to do it this time. I don't know. I'm doing a lot better than I was the previous run, though. Try this again. I was really trying to beat that snowball because it didn't look like it was in the way like that one. They have minds of their own. Shoot. I pretty much only had one more chance. There it is. A pain in the butt. And we get the Santee hat. Plus 20 armor though, that's actually really helpful. Okay. Is there anything else over here? Now this is like back the way I came, I think. Alrighty, so let's go through the gate over here. If you notice, there's like these blocks in the way. Of course, there's enemies in them. Huh. Okay, and legendary Chop Chop. Just leveled up? I was gonna say, he's about to level up. I forgot he has that jump. Ow. Wait, that didn't hurt. There's a new enemy here. The Ice Ogre. Okay. Yeah, he takes quite a few hits to take down, but it's not that bad. They're actually kind of slow, so... yeah, that helps out. There's a treasure chest back there. We'll try to get that one. Actually, that was a bad idea. Now those snowballs are going to be rolling around everywhere. Okay, they didn't come over this side.
Wahoo! I found this here key! Hey, looks like you found it too! It looks like these bozos are defending it, so watch out! Wahoo! That there key should open that there gate! Then I'll show you my masterful plan of mastery!
Yeah, I reckon. Alright, so... like you said, we're actually gonna encounter some enemies here. Oops. Actually, you can see the chucker up there with the story scroll. Yeah, he can reach him from down here. We're gonna go around though, just so we can get the story scroll too. Oh, here's a new one. Yeah, he's the same as the other ones, but like his description said, he just has a little hat on. Alrighty. See, that jumping move he has is actually really useful, because you can actually move a lot faster. Take that. We'll get that treasure chest in a moment. Let's get rid of the rest of these enemies, but first we'll get the story scroll.
Stories are still told about the greatest catapult ever built. The Leveler, which has defended the warm valley of Vindelvale for centuries. Without the Leveler, there is little chance that Vindelvale could defend itself against the cold, loving armies of Ice Ogres and Snowclopses that dwell nearby.
Okay. These two to deal with? Well, that... okay, they're both dead. Alright. Oh, the dragon treasure is right there. Conveniently right next to the regular treasure chest. Okay, this will help because legendary Chop Chop definitely needs that sword upgrade. The one that makes his sword like into like a giant blade. Don't tell me I can't reach that. Oh wait, he can jump, so so I'm still missing a lot. I don't think I've gotten to the point where I can get these missing items, though. Alright, we're gonna backtrack to where that gate was once I can get up here. Oh, I still need to show off the items too. I'll do that once there's like a big group of enemies.
Wahoo! We only need a few more parts to fix this old catapult and show those ice ogres so-and-so's a thing or three. Grab that there next piece, then hop on that weird swirly thing to find the next one after that.
Okay. Well, I don't think there's a way to go back, so...
Skylanders of the undead element are stronger in this zone.
Oh, I didn't even... I wasn't paying attention. Alright, well, I'll stick with Legendary Chop Chop then. There's some treasure there. If you notice, there was a bomb spot back there. There's one here. We'll get to that eventually. Alright. Okay, when we get down here... He's about to attack. Okay, so this is the first magic item that comes with Empire of Ice. Oops. I accidentally took Legendary Chop Chop off too. Oops.
Bones to battle.
Okay, what this does, it increases your defense. So, I don't really need that. And said back to water. Instead of going back to Slam Bam, I might pick somebody else. Let's go with, where the heck is... Oh, here he is. Ramp shot. Okay. So, the next one here is the Anvil Rain. And it's pretty self-explanatory. And you do get the bonus for it if you have a Skylander of that element. If you noticed, it did a little bit more damage to the enemy. So, those are the two magic items that come with Empire of Ice. And if you actually put the Empire of Ice, doesn't matter where you are, what chapter you are, you put it on the portal. Actually, it does like an icicle rain. The effect is very, very short if you noticed. So, if you have to use it, you only get, I think, one shot at it. Let me double check. Yeah, you only get one shot. You should do it when there's a lot of enemies on screen and you're, like, in desperate need of assistance. I don't remember... Yeah, I need to... I need to upgrade him a lot, too. Okay, but yeah, like I mentioned, I will show off the magic items for each adventure pack. The Skylander that comes with it, and then what the adventure pack does if you use it in-game. Okay, he's getting hit a lot here. I don't know if he's the best choice for this one. I think it's weird how, like, the, those ogre guys, like, when they're defeated, they kind of just, like, walk off and fade away instead of, like, fall over and get defeated. It just looks kind of weird. Alright, let's head in here. Okay, this is another maze like we saw when we got Slam Bam's Soul Gem. Except there's like mad holes everywhere. But there's a button here. Okay. Oops. He's not the most, like, mobile guy here, so... Can't really make too many fast moves with him. Alright, so that's the exit. I don't think there's anything else here. I didn't see anything. Okay, and there's the... I think that's the legendary treasure right there, and then the gift. Oh wait, no, that's... that's the part.
Wahoo! Now get! Bring that sucker back to the catapult!
Okay. Well, before we actually do that... Jesus, stupid cactus. We need to hit the button, and then I'm gonna grab the... hat. See if I can make it over there. Getting hit back and forth, but I opened it. The Cossack hat. Okay. So, I like how the two hats that you get in here are kind of fitting with the environment. Very cool.
Just need one more part here. Aw, cripes. It's probably over in that battlefield area. Dad burns Cyclops territory. I should warn you, they use real artillery shells instead of snowballs.
Skylanders of the undead element are stronger in this zone.
Just use that exploding ball over there to clear the way. Wahoo!
Okay, I'm gonna not use him. Because... mobility is a little limited. So slow. Okay, before we actually bomb that part, let's go back here and bomb the wall that's hidden here. And we get the legendary treasure. Does he need it though? He does, okay. It's actually a really cool one, too. Unfortunately, you only get 500. If you remember, in the last few chapters, Legendary Treasure has got, like, over 1,000 gold. Alright, so let's grab the bomb, bomb the wall, and then go beyond that. I did not know you can actually hit the old man. It's pretty interesting. Like you said, yeah, they're actually gonna fire at you. It's calling for a tech element. Alright, so somebody tech. I think I can tell what's under these. Nice. Yeah, I need to upgrade him too, because he has like this upgrade. Actually, the pot of gold turns into like a giant coin. I actually haven't seen what that looked like yet in game. Looks very useful because it's much bigger than the pot of gold and it does more damage as well. Okay. Oh, it's interesting you fire backwards. Oh, he died already. Yeah, you can get like a little boost. Like a backwards boost. Yeah, more enemies. does so much damage. It's crazy. Alright. What am I missing here? Oops. One treasure chest, which I'm not really worried about. Okay. This song is really catchy. Oh, actually the last one is right out in the open. Alright, so we got everything, so there's nothing to worry about. No, okay. Ah. Last piece.
Good gravy, you did it! Now just come on back to the catapult! Wahoo!
Alright, just watch out for the additional cannon fire.
Skylanders of the undead element are stronger in this zone.
We are back in business. Ooh, we're gonna give those Ice Ogres walls such a catapulting. And you know what's better than launching snowballs? Fireballs!
Okay, so in this part, you need to do is aim at the wall, destroy all the stuff on there. I do recommend trying to get rid of the cannons and stuff like that so they don't bother you. Okay, on the Wii, you hold the A button, it charges it back a little bit more. You know, obviously the more you hold it, the farther up the fireballs go. Got two more cannons. Yeah, there's a barrel there. Some other stuff come flying at you. Cannonballs, all that stuff. The food, obviously, is safe. You can eat that if you need it. Okay. This does take a little bit, though. If you notice on the right side, that's the health meter of the wall, and it's still pretty high. Finish off the rest of these tower things. And we've had Donkey Kong ride the wall here, throwing mad barrels at us. I was gonna say, how much punishment is that gonna take? I was hoping that would destroy that top part too. I mean, it would make sense, but you know. Yeah, this is kind of the boring part because nothing's really going on. You're just basically just shooting the wall until it crumbles down. But you don't have to worry about any enemy fire or whatever. This part's kind of annoying because you have to push the A button in just right, so that it doesn't go that high or that low. It's way too high. There we go.
I haven't said huzzah in years. It's always been wahoo! But now that you've saved our valley and brought back spring, oh, it's huzzah forever! I can feel the air warming up already. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm off to put on my swimming trunks.
All right, that was the Empire of Ice. That was a fun level. The next one we're gonna do is Pirate Seas. Okay, so like I said, we're gonna do Pirate Seas in the next video. All right, see you next time.